Imagine fast Wi-Fi didn't exist. Your laptop would be tied to a desk. We'd have spiderwebs of cables everywhere. Thankfully, the wireless wonder of fast Wi-Fi has saved us from digital chains. It all began with a journey into deep space to discover black holes. It was the 80s, a time of fluorescent clothes and time-travelling DeLoreans. Computer networks were becoming crucial in all areas of life. But at this point, computers were all connected together with cables. Scientists were trying to cut the cords and send the data over radio, but it just bounced off walls and furniture and Depeche Mode cassettes, interfering with itself and causing a smeary, useless mess. As luck would have it, the problem had been solved years before. Wind back even further to the 70s, the decade that gave us disco and Star Wars. John O'Sullivan and his team at CSIRO's Radio Astronomy Unit were trying to detect radio signals from distant exploding black holes. Tiny ones, smaller than atoms. To group the faint signals from space into something meaningful, they came up with complex equations called fast Fourier transforms. It was ingenious. But they didn't find any black holes. So that was that. But flash forward to the 90s. For some Nirvana and X-Files, John and his team decided to have a crack at wireless networking and took those fancy fast Fourier transforms off the shelf. With those equations, they were able to unsmear the data being sent over radio and formed the basis for fast Wi-Fi. Then in 1996, the US Patent and Trademark Office granted a patent to CSIRO. While different types of Wi-Fi tech were developed by others, our fast Wi-Fi has taken over the market. That means there's over 5 billion devices around the world connecting to networks using our black hole hunting technology. You're probably using it right now, so let us know if you see any black holes.